Consider a overhang beam, and in this beam there are two support at point B and at point C, and this is your overhang beam. Two point loads are acting at point A and D, and one UDL is acting. Now in this problem I will give you the concept of how to find the point of contraflexure. Now first of all we will start with finding the reaction at point A and C by using the equations of equilibrium. Now in order to find the reactions we will use the two equations of equilibrium. First of all we will take movement about point B and equate all the clockwise movement into anticlockwise movement. So we take movement about point B, the various clockwise movement will be 7 at point B, 7 into 6. This is the clockwise movement. The UDL movement will be 5 into 4 acting at the center, 4 by 2. This is also a clockwise movement about point B. The movement of RC will be RC into 4. This will be anticlockwise. And about point B, the movement of 3 will be 3 into 1. This will also be anticlockwise movement. So we will equate the clockwise movement equal to anticlockwise movement, and by solving this equation we will get RC equal to 19.75 kilonewton. Other equation of equilibrium is that all the upward load will be equal to downward load. Now in this figure you will see upward load will be RB RC. This is upward load, where downward load will be 7, 3 and 5 into 4. This is the downward load. So we will equate these two loads and substitute the value of RC in this equation. You will be able to find the value of RB. That will come out to be 10.25 kilonewton. So after calculating the reactions, now we will find the shear force at various point D, C, B, A by using the sign convention and taking either right hand side of the beam or left hand side of the beam. So we will consider the right hand side of the beam and we will calculate the shear force. The sign convention for a right hand side of the beam is that all the downward force is taken as positive, all the upward force will be taken as negative. So we'll start from point D, the downward force 7, so that will be positive. So the shear force at point D will be equal to plus 7 kilonewton. Now at point C, the shear force will be, now from point D to C, there is no load acting. Hence, there will not be any change in shear force. So at point C, the shear force will be this, that is downward, plus the value of RC. Now the RC is upward. Upward force will be taken as negative. So the shear force at point C will be plus 7 downward, whereas minus RC upward. This comes out to be, after substituting the value of RC, this comes out to be minus 12.75 kilonewton. Now we will find the shear force at point B. Now from C to B, you will say UDL is continuously increasing. So first of all, due to this UDL, we will find how much is the shear force which approaches the point B. And then after that, we will find the shear force at point B by adding this value. First of all, we will find what is the shear force at point B due to this UDL and all the other right hand side forces. So due to this UDL, the shear force will be at point B, this is downward, that is taken as positive, upward taken as negative, and at point B, 5 into 4, that is again 1/4 force is acting. So this will be equal to shear force approaches B, that is at point C, this is the force, and we will add the shear force due to UDL, 5 into 4, that will be 7.25 kilonewton. So we reaches at point B. We can also find the shear force at point B by considering the left hand side of the beam. Now if we consider the left hand side of the beam, the various sign conventions will be all the downward forces will be taken as negative, whereas all the upward forces will be taken as positive. Now we'll start from point A. At point A, there is only one force acting, that is your minus 3 kilonewton. So downward force is taken as negative, minus 3 kilonewton. the shear force at point B will be equal to minus 3 plus RB. So this will be minus 3 plus RB, that is 7.25 kilonewton. So it is easy to find the shear force at point B by considering the left hand side of the section. So after calculating all the shear forces, now we will plot the shear force diagram. We will start from point D. The shear force at point D was 7 kilonewton. So this will be vertical load, a vertical line. So this is 7 kilonewton. From D to C, there is no load. Hence, the shear force line will be horizontal. We reach point C. So at point C, the shear force changes to minus 12.75. Now we can see here, at point C, there is a vertical load. Hence, on the shear force, the line will be a vertical line. And we will reach negative downward 12.75 kilonewton. Clear? And the shear force at point C was 12.75 kilonewton. Now when we reaches at point B, the shear force in positive direction, and how much we have calculated, that is 7.25 kilonewton. Now this is a UDL. Whenever there is a UDL, the shear force line will always be inclined. So we will reach point B where the shear force was 7.25 kilonewton. Now by considering the other side of the left hand side of the section, shear force at A was minus 3. So minus 3 we mean downward. So shear force at A is minus 3. Line is vertical because load is vertical. From A to B there is no change in load. Therefore the line will be horizontal. So this is your 3 kilonewton. Again at point B, vertical load reaction. So negative, positive, positive. This is positive, negative, positive, positive. So this is your shear force diagram. Now we will try to find the bending moment at various point, and then we will plot the bending moment diagram. Now in order to calculate the bending moment at various point, again we will consider either the left hand section of the beam or right hand section of the beam. So let us suppose we consider the right hand section of the beam, and we will use a sign convention. On right side, all the clockwise movement are taken as negative, whereas all the anti-clockwise movement will be taken as your positive. Now we will find the bending moment at various point. Start from point D. The bending moment of 7 kilonewton at point D will be 0. Bending moment is force into perpendicular distance. So whenever there is some distance at which the force is acting, it will have movement. If it is acting at that point, the movement will be 0. Now the bending moment at point C, considering right hand side of the beam, this will be 7 into 2, and this will be in clockwise direction. Therefore the movement will be negative, minus 7 into 2, 14 kilonewton meter. Now to find bending moment at point B, it is easy if we consider left hand side of the beam. If we consider right hand side of the beam, the answer will come out to be same. Just for practice, find the bending moment at point B by considering the right hand side of the beam. So the bending moment at point B will be 7 into 6 clockwise negative, RC into 4 anti-clockwise positive, 5 into 4, that is a force, and distance will be center into 2. So this will come out to be 7 into 6 plus RC into 4 minus 5 into 4 into half of the distance. So this will become out to be minus 3 kilonewton meter. Now we will start from left hand side of the beam and take movement about point A. The sign convention when we take left hand side of the beam are that all the anti-clockwise movement will be taken as negative, whereas clockwise movement will be taken as positive. Now bending movement of 3 kN about point A will be 0. So bending movement at A will be 0. Bending moment at B will be, by considering left hand side, only one force, 3 into 1, and direction will be anti-clockwise, negative, minus 3 into 1, that is minus 3 kN. So you can see the answer come out to be same. Now we will plot the bending moment diagram. Bending moment at point D, 0, at point A, 0. Now if you see the shear force diagram, at point B, at point E, at point C, the shear force is changing the direction. That is, at point B the shear force is 0, at point E the shear force is 0, at point C the shear force is 0. So on these three points, the bending moment will be maximum on any of these three points. So first of all, we will find locate the bending moment which we have calculated. The bending moment at C is minus 14. So bending moment at C will be minus 14. Shear force line is horizontal. So bending moment line will be your inclined line. Like this. Clear? So whenever this is the relation between the shear force diagram and the bending moment diagram, that is whenever there is a horizontal line on in the shear force diagram, the bending moment line will always be inclined like this. So we will write down the values. The value is bending moment at C, the value is minus 14. See downward, minus 14. Similarly, bending moment at A was 0, clear? And the bending moment at B was minus 3. This line is horizontal, so this will be inclined line, straight line inclined. So this will be your 3 minus 3 kilonewton meter. Now see here, at point B, we have already know the bending moment. At point C, we already know the bending moment. So now we will find what is the bending moment at point E. Now we will try to locate the point E. So point E is basically that point at which your shear force is 0. So if you see the shear force diagram, at point B, E and C, the shear force changes its sign. Therefore, as I told you, maximum bending moment will occur at either B, E or C. Now, in order to locate this point, this is 7.25, this is 12.75. By using similar triangle concepts, you can also find the distance X. Okay, at what distance X this point E is being located. Now, in this case, I have used the method that I will find the shear force at point E by considering the left hand side of the beam. So this is your point E and this distance is X. This is point E. So we will find how much shear force is acting at point E. The shear force acting at point E is, consider left hand side of the beam. How much force are acting? 3 downward minus RB upward positive, and then this much of UDL, 5 into X downward. So total shear force at point X will be equal to minus 3 plus RB minus 5 into X. So, and how much will be the shear force? This will be 0. So by equating this, we will be able to find the value of X that come out to be 1.45 meter. Clear? Now we know that at this point the bending moment will be maximum. And now we will try to find the bending moment at point E. Similarly, what will be the bending moment at point E? See the load, bending moment at point E will be 3 into 1 plus x. That will be anti-clockwise, negative. Then RB into x, that will be clockwise, positive. And then bending moment of the UDL, 5 into x by 2. So this is the calculation. And the maximum bending moment come out to be 2.25 kilo Newton meter. That is positive. So in the diagram, this will be your positive value, 2.25 kilo Newton meter. You can check the calculation again. The bending moment at point E, by substituting the value of x as 1.45, we have calculated that the bending moment at point E is 2.25 kilonewton meter. Now we plot all the points. If the shear force line is inclined, bending moment line will be curve, parabolic curve, like this. And here also it will be curve like this. So this will be your negative, this will be positive, this will be negative. So this is point A, B, point E. You are having maximum bending moment, that is positive, 2.25. And this is point C, this is point D. So this is your shear force and bending moment diagram. Now we'll come to the point of contraflexure. Now what is the point of contraflexure? Now you can see the figure of bending moment diagram. Now bending moment diagram figure, there are basically two points. This is one point. Suppose this is point F. And this is another point. Suppose point G. So at these two points, you will see that the bending moment becomes zero or changes its sign. And these two points are said to be the point of contraflexure. So the point of contraflexures are those point at which your bending moment is zero or bending moment changes its sign. Now how to locate these two points? Now, similarly, we will take the distance of point F or point G from any of the support, say support B. Now we will assume that this point F lie at a distance Y, or in the load diagram you see that this distance, this is your point F. We'll assume this distance to be Y. So we will assume that the point F is lying at a distance of Y from support. So this is, we have assumed that from this point to this point, the distance is Y. Clear? Now we will try to find the bending moment at point F. What will be the bending moment at point F? Again, we will consider only left side of the beam. Bending moment at F is 0. Clear? So how much is the bending moment? 3 into 1 plus Y. Anticlockwise, negative. Then RB into Y, clockwise, negative. And this much of UDL, that is 5 into Y. This UDL is 5 into Y by 2. So this is the bending moment at point F by considering the left hand side of the beam. So we will solve this equation. Now this is a quality equation. We will divide whole of the equation by minus 2.5. We will get y square minus 2.9y plus 1.2 equal to 0. And by using the quadratic equation formula, that is root will be equal to y will be minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a, we will be able to find the value of y. So the value of y after calculation comes out to be 3.85 or 0.5, which means that this point lie at a distance of 3.85 or 0.5. That is, from this point to this point, the distance will be 0.5. Another point was this point G. B to G, the distance will be equal to 3.85. And these two points, point F and point G, are said to be your point of contraflexure. So point of contraflexures are 0.5 from B or 3.85 from B. That is, distance BF will be equal to your 0.5 and distance BG will be equal to your 3.85. So in this way, we are able to find the point of contraflexure. Thank you.